Like many people this week, I spent my Thanksgiving break with my family in my hometown, enjoying good food and having fun. To keep up the Thanksgiving spirit, for this video I wanted to try out a recipe that uses flavors that are a bit more personal to me. Though turkey is obviously a holiday tradition in my home, another food that has been used for cooking quite frequently by my family is apples. In honor of this tradition, we're going to try making the apple dumplings from Skyrim. This recipe is a little more complicated since we're making the dough from scratch, but you can always make it easier for yourself by buying pre-made from the store. The recipe I decided to use this time around was created by the King Arthur Flour Company. Like last time, I'll post a link to the original recipe in the description so you can see why I decided to change. Here are the ingredients that we'll be using for the dough. This time, make sure that the butter is still cold before use, as this is important for how we will end up combining it with the flour. First, we're going to mix the dry ingredients together with a whisk until fully combined. As a reminder, this is the flour, baking powder, salt, and sugar. Once that's done, we're going to cut the butter into the dry mixture. Generally, a food processor is the best way to do this, but since I don't have one of those, I'll be demonstrating the low-tech way with a dough cutter. If you don't have one of your own, they're pretty easy to buy. After cubing the butter, use a dough cutter to break it into smaller pieces and mix it into the dry mix. This will end up taking some time, but keep at it until the butter is in relatively pea-sized pieces. Next, add 3/4 cup of milk and stir until the dough is fully combined. If it looks like the dough needs more liquid, you can add up to another 1/4 cup in small intervals until the dough comes together. Remember, you can always add more liquid, but you can't take it away. Once the dough is finished, split it into 2 halves and separately wrap them in plastic wrap. We'll leave these to chill in the freezer for around 30 minutes while we move on to the filling. Also remember at this point to start preheating your oven to 375 degrees. For the filling, you'll need 4 relatively smaller sized apples. Granny Smiths are traditionally used, but I personally use Pink Ladies since they're a bit smaller. After washing the apples, you'll want to core and peel them. Remember to save the peels as we'll be using them later in the syrup. Slice each apple in half on the equator and put them off to the side. If you want to keep them from browning, you can also sprinkle them with a tablespoon of lemon juice. Next up is the syrup, which you'll need these ingredients for. For the syrup, combine the brown sugar, peels, and water in a saucepan and leave over medium heat. Once that is boiling, reduce the heat to a simmer and leave for around 10 minutes. Once it is done cooking, pour the syrup through a strainer to remove the apple peels and then mix in the lemon juice. Now we can start assembling the dumplings. Make sure your workspace is well floured before removing half the dough from the freezer. Start off by rolling the dough into a 12 by 12 square. Don't be too concerned if the dough is thin by this point, as we don't want it to be too thick once we start adding the filling. Next, split the square into 4 dumplings by cutting it into 4 6-inch squares. On each square, place an apple half in the middle and sprinkle it with a tablespoon of sugar cinnamon mixture. For the mixture, you'll need half a cup of granulated sugar, 1 teaspoon cinnamon, and 1/4 teaspoon nutmeg. Now we're going to fold the dough over the apple to completely cover it. Take each corner and pull into the center of the dumpling, making sure to tuck them together. When you finish the first 4 dumplings, repeat the process with the other half of the dough. Once all the dumplings are complete, place them seam side up in the pan. You can now pour the syrup over the dumplings, making sure to keep the spread even. Don't add all the syrup at once because you don't want to completely drown them as they bake. To bake, it should take around 45 to 50 minutes. While monitoring the dumplings, you should look for the point when the apples turn tender and the pastry is brown. Here we have the finished product. I really enjoyed how these dumplings tasted, as they reminded me of the apple cider I used to drink as a kid. Though some of them did end up looking a little rugged, I think they definitely look like something that you could find being served in an inn. Let me know in the comments how this recipe went in your kitchens, if you have any feedback on the video itself, or if you just want to chat. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.